Namaskar learners, I am Mansi Sanghvi and welcome to the National Institute of Open Schooling Studio. As you are well aware, we bring to you various audio and video programs on a plethora of subjects. And today as well, we have a very interesting subject, sociology. Dr. Elena Somanthre, she is a faculty and a sociologist. She is a faculty with V.V. Giri National Labour Institute under Ministry of Labour and Employment, Government of India. Welcome Mr. Sukant Mahapatra. He is Academic Officer of Sociology at NIOS. Dr. Elena, can you please explain to us what is social structure?
Yes, sure. I will just start with an example that if a person is a learner, like you all are learners with NIOS, you have been following a strict discipline pattern of life because you have to accommodate your learning interests and you have to also carry out your routine everyday daily activities. So your structural arrangements have, you know, compelled you to behave in a particular pattern. Similarly, if you are employed somewhere and you are also a learner at NIOS, you arrange your everyday daily routine activities like brushing, taking care of everyday activities and doing regular duties as per your schedule, which is given to you by the structure which is followed, which is comfortable for you working as an employee and also comfortable for you doing learning activities for NIOS. So a structure governs your everyday routine activities. In fact, structure provides you an ordered arrangement of where you, how to behave, where to behave and what kind of behavior you have to do when you are a member of that particular structure.
Mr. Sukant, can you please explain the concept of social structure?
Before that, I'll say what is structure and then I'll explain what is social structure. So structure comes from Latin word struer, which means to build. So structure means an arrangement of parts in which every part has a function to do. So we can say that every society has a system and a system has units, and without the function of one unit, other unit cannot function properly.
Dr. Elena, so what is the definition of social structure?
Yeah, in sociology, there is no standard or agreed definition of social structure. But if we talk about social structure in a very sociological sense given by different sociologists, it means ordered arrangement of parts where each and every part of the social structure are interrelated so that they can perform a particular function. So these parts in connection with each other perform towards, contribute towards maintaining of the whole society. For example, there are various norms, customs, values, belief systems in a society which are interrelated with each other in different social institutions, and they contribute towards maintaining the value consensus of the society. That is how a social structure operates in a society.
So what are the characteristics of social structure?
Yeah, social structure has a number of characteristics, and one of them is that it should be governed by norms. Every individual performs his roles according to the social norms. We can say that in Indian society, we have certain kind of norms and it differs from other kind of society. Suppose what is an American society, that norms may not be in Indian society, and what is an Indian society, that may not be in American society. For example, we can say that old age home concept is coming off, but that is not very much popular in Indian society in comparison to other societies, because here we believe in the system of karma and dharma. We say that suppose if you are not behaving to a particular individual in a better manner, so you cannot expect that. So if you are saying that we'll send our parents, those who have become old, to the old age homes, it may happen that at our time, our son may send to us to the old age homes. So proper functioning of social structure depends on one's position and one's role. We can take the example of a family where there is father, mother, son and daughter. Everyone has its own function and one's role. So once, if one deviates from his or her own role, so we cannot have a smooth social or smooth family. We can say that, take another example, suppose a girl take up number of roles. when she basically goes to the office, she behaves in a particular manner. When she becomes a housewife, she behaves in a particular manner. And when she as a daughter, her role also varies. So we can say that social structure depends on performance of one's position and role.
Dr. Elena, would you like to add something to it?
Yes, I would like to say that one of the important characteristics of social structure is socially approved norms of the society. Any behavior which is under a structural arrangement needs to be approved by the society. For example, members of the society are expected to behave in a particular manner which is acceptable by the members of the society. That means, to be precise,
yeah,
it should be socially sanctioned by the members of the society. For example, a girl child who is married and goes to a particular family is expected to behave in a particular manner if it is a different kind of family. If it is a joint family where there are in-laws,
yeah,
present, then she has to maintain behavior pattern, like giving respect to the senior or elder members in the family. If it is a nuclear family where there are no members present, then she might behave in a different way, which the structural arrangement of the family proposes. So that is how, when we are in a social structure or we adhere to the norms of the social structure, we always behave in such a manner where the society sanctions a particular kind of,
yeah,
behavior. The moment we stop behaving in a manner which the society has not proposed us to do, then we may be viewed as someone who is deviating from the social,
yeah,
norms.
Yes.
It means, in a sense, that a doctor in a hospital cannot be talking on the phone wasting time. He has to be there attending to his patients, whereas a person in a call center has to be on the phone all the time doing what the,
yeah,
society expects,
yes,
him to do in a call center.
Yeah.
Exactly. The similar behavior pattern is expected from, you know, students. Students are expected to be disciplined. Students are expected to give full justice to the text, full justice to the readings they are doing, and full justice to whatever they are studying.
Yeah.
So that is how we make a discipline pattern of life. That is how, you know, social sanctioning or social norms actually make us discipline in a manner which is arranged, you know, institutionalized and even approved by the society.
Yeah.
So we,
yeah,
actually behave in a manner where the society has,
yeah,
not only approved us to behave, but the society also would actually be looking at our behavior patterns in a,
yeah,
particular way it has to be.
So they expect us to behave in a particular way.
Exactly.
Like in your earlier role, you said when a girl gets married, she behaves in a particular way.
Hmm.
Similarly, when a boy gets married, he also becomes a husband. So,
yeah,
he also behaves in a particular manner.
Yes, yes.
So everybody then accordingly has to change their ways,
yes,
of lifestyle,
yeah,
and their behavior.
Right, right.
Then system can function properly.
Yes.
Yes. And as a result, the society as a whole can function very,
yes,
well.
And another characteristic which I would like to highlight to the learners is social structure also operates on a system of anticipated response.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like there is an anticipated response on the behavior patterns of an individual. Like sometimes in sociology, we say it is a typified behavior patterns.
Yeah.
For example, a teacher,
yeah,
who is going to a classroom to deliver a lecture is supposed to behave in a particular manner to deliver a lecture. That,
yeah,
is how the students perceive the teacher as someone who has to be serious about studies, who has to deliver the lecture in a particular manner. And that is how, you know, it is an anticipated,
yeah,
response. Like students would be sitting in a very disciplined manner because they expect that the teacher is coming to the class. The moment there is a time for the teacher to come, they behave in a particular manner. They maintain the minimum classroom decorum.
Yeah.
And they also believe that the teacher who is entering the classroom would be sitting in a particular manner, talking in a particular manner.
Yeah.
This is how, you know, is an anticipated response,
yeah,
of the members of the society, there itself in the social structure, embedded in the very,
yeah,
nature of social structure.
I understand. If you see a red light and if you're driving the car, you stop.
Yes.
Yeah.
And,
yes,
if you see a green light, you start driving.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's how.
Yes. So Dr. Elena, how is social structure different from social organization?
Yes. Social organization means actually groups of people who are organized towards pursuing a particular goal. It may be an association, it may be a religious organization, it may be any organization which has a particular goal in its mind, and it should be working towards a particular strategy to reach that goal. So, but a social structure is something where an organization can be a part of the social structure. A social structure, in fact, to be more precise, would be having a larger scope than a social organization. Many social organizations can be a part of social structure. For example, you can have youth clubs, you can have religious associations, you can have sports club within a particular social structure. That is how an organization operates. Moreover, if we look into the differences, social organizations always specifies on maintaining a coordinated relationship or maintaining a system of relationships. Like, we are organized for a purpose, we have a particular goal in mind, we would pursue that goal. In case of a social structure, it's not necessary that they will be, you know, having a well-coordinated system of relationships, but the parts of the structure are coordinated. For example, like the parts of a body, your hands, legs and eyes, mouth, everything is coordinated for the smooth functioning of the body, right? Similarly, the parts of a social structure, be it religious institution, political institution, economic institution, every institution can work at their own individual level without being, you know, associated with each other on a face-to-face basis, but contribute towards the maintaining of the whole social structure. That is how it operates. I mean, the scope expands in case of social structure, but when we talk about social organization, since it is a smaller entity where people might be focusing on face-to-face relationships and might be discussing on a face-to-face basis for pursuing a particular goal.
We can take an example, like suppose we in a social structure we have police, like legal system, we have, then we have political system, then we have economic system. So they perform their own roles, and that gives a complete society.
So the end goal is the same in this case, the smooth running of the country, whereas that independent roles are separately stated to them, and they're working harmoniously together.
Yes. And social organization actually focuses on maintaining social relationships. But social structure, as I already mentioned, it has got a more larger scope. Like, it not only focuses on maintaining social relationships, it also focuses on, you know, coordination of various aspects of the structure, so that the structures contribute either in a coordinated manner towards the maintenance of the whole entire structure. That is how it operates, along with maintaining a balance in social relationships.
So, what is the basis of a social structure?
The basis are the ordered arrangements of parts, how the parts of the structure are arranged with each other. So, like, for example, a particular economic system would not function without a political system in a country. Like, for a country like India, if we have an economic system, it has to be connected with the political system, with
and
other
that means
systems.
We need to pursue a goal. When suppose we are in the economic system, we have a role of production and distribution. And equal, suppose we are producing, but if we are not distributing equally or according to our own goals, then the problem occurs. Suppose we have sufficient production, but we are not distributing equally. We are not distributing because there are number of people, those who want that, that is to distribute it. So we have to need to pursue a goal. And second thing, we have to prepare to accept one's role and status. As a son, I have my own roles, I have to perform that. As a father has to perform his role. So we have to prepare one's status and role. And then there are norms and mores. These are the basis of social structure.
Yes. And then, for example, to be to make the learners maybe more clear about it. For example, if we take a religious institution, it becomes a social structure then. Within that religion, religious institution, you have a mosque, you have a temple, you have a church, which are organizations which are working towards for pursuing those religious interests.
So various organizations make an entire structure.
Exactly.
Okay. So what is the relationship between a social structure and a social system?
Before explaining social structure and social relationship between social structure and social system, first, I want to explain what is social system. System generally means an orderly arrangement of constituent units. And the main features of social system are it is made up of different parts. There must be systematic relationship between different parts. Arrangement of these parts should create a pattern, and then there is a functional relationship among the parts of system. As we told earlier, there are many examples that it is made up of different parts. Suppose we told that a political system, we have economic system, we have legal system. So these are related and they follow a pattern.
But they have to work together.
Yeah.
Simultaneously.
Yes.
Yes.
So then how do we define a social system, Dr. Elena?
Yeah, when we go towards a particular sociological definition of a social system, we say that it is a theoretical scheme, as many scholars, many sociologists like Talcott Parsons, who have worked on social system in their books, they have mentioned that it's a theoretical scheme,
yeah,
which articulates our own field with others and which are equally a part of some broader fundamental
yes
system. That's how Parsons perceives a social system as a system. It can be itself a part of any larger system,
yeah,
but as a part, it would be also fulfilling certain functions
yes
in that particular system. So, as Mr. Mahapatra was also saying that in a system, it becomes very important to do the functions also.
Yeah.
That's how, you know, many structural functionalists like Parsons, when they perceive a structure, when they talk about a structure, they also perceive a function attached to it. So, every system has got a function attached to it. So, when we talk about a definition of a social system, we say they are actually operational manuals. They are operational manuals for maintaining of social structure. They actually provide guidelines on how to maintain the social structure.
Yes.
That is how a system works. And if to be to giving exam to give to be giving some examples on this would be norms, customs, etc. These are the operational manuals
yeah
on how a system should operate,
yeah,
and they provide appropriate guidelines for functioning of the system.
Yeah.
So that is how many sociologists have perceived on the social system.
So then could it be this, that if, for example, if you're driving a car, the manual is you have to change the gear,
exactly,
press the brake, and then the entire social structure means the entire overlay of roads and the signals,
yeah,
exactly,
and everyone
right
driving simultaneously.
Yes, right.
I can give an example. Suppose the driver is going, so there is rules and regulations. So when he goes, there is a traffic system which gives the direction that I have to control myself and have to go to a disciplined manner. And sometimes, suppose if he'll go, then there is a chance of accident.
Right.
And when accident occurs, so he thinks about what kind of medical expenditure will be there. So I have to be very cautious.
What are the characteristics of a social system?
Yeah, social system is based on, you know, interaction of plurality of individuals, and this interaction should have a meaning.
Yeah.
A famous prominent sociologist, Emile Durkheim, he talked about, you know, social actions being given a meaning.
Yeah.
Like any action which is termed as social action need to have a meaning attached to it. That means the meaning should be it should be in a such a direction that where the goals and ends of the action needs
yeah
to be
yeah
are very clear cut, and
yeah
the actor knows about the appropriate strategy to reach the end or the goal. So when we talk about a social system, it means an interaction of plurality of individuals, and that interaction has to be meaningful in nature. It should convey some meaning, it should come out with a appropriate meaning and appropriate course of action.
Yeah.
Then as a system, as a unity, various parts of the system like the institutions, your customs,
yeah,
traditions, then value preferences,
yeah,
laws, they are arranged in an integrated manner.
Yeah.
So that is how this is what is an important characteristic of a system,
yeah,
where all the parts are integrated in a whole.
Yeah.
And there is also a functional relationship existing between these parts.
Yeah.
All these parts are in fact functionally interdependent upon
yeah
each other.
Yeah.
That is how.
Suppose we can take an example of NISL system. We have a department of evaluation department, we have academic department, we have SSS department.
Hmm.
Suppose when a student takes admission, so there is academic department who does all the preparing of self-learning materials, then also deliver audio and video lectures, and we send all this audio and video to our student also. And we have student support services. Suppose student face any kind of problem, so they can contact student support services.
Hmm.
And we have an evaluation department. Suppose for examination or other activities, those related to examination and evaluation. The student can have their query reserved from them. So there are three systems. And the one in academic, one in SSS, another evaluation department.
Yeah, I would also like to say in this regard, like the famous sociologist Emile Durkheim would reiterate in his book Division of Labor in Society, he talks about a kind of division of labor existing in society among its members, even knowing the fact that with when the time when there is a passage of time, society becomes complex from simple, but labor becomes divided among its members, and on the basis of this division of labor, there would be a healthy competition in terms of, you know, how the roles and responsibilities of people belonging to particular groups or particular, as Sukant ji was rightly saying, that how in NIOS different departments work. It's the same. If you take up the factory or an industry setting, workers, the managers, the top level officers, they all are coordinated with each other or integrated with each other through their functions. If the worker stops working, then the entire factory machinery is disrupted. Yes. So that is how they are integrated. That is how labor is divided among different groups of people, so that it is contributing to the functioning of the factory. And then Durkheim very beautifully said in his doctoral work, Division of Labor, that it also enables people in the society to maintain a kind of solidarity. And solidarity is brotherhood, actually, through our interdependence, which is functional. Durkheim very rightly says that people are interdependent with each other through their roles, which is functional, and this functional interdependence helps in maintaining solidarity. Like, we might be competing with each other, but that is a healthy competition, because we all are contributing towards the maintenance of the whole, and that is the factory or industry or any institution where all of us are working together and doing our coordinated efforts.
So we are striving to be the best, and in which case it's a healthy competition. Although we know that even our colleague is doing the same thing, and we're working towards reaching the same goal.
Exactly.
And social system is also related to the cultural system. You can say that, suppose when a child is grown up, the parents want to make her marry or make him marry, but they can, but there are certain rules and regulations. Because before, if there are some age, like 21 and 18,
so, like
so before
legal,
that they cannot marry.
There's a legal limit allocated by the government.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So, Dr. Elena, what is the basis of a social system?
Yes, when we talk about the basis of social system, it talks about its constituent elements or the foundations on which a system rests. And if we look at the basis, the beliefs, norms, power, all these are the basis of the social system. Sanction facility, how a society perceives sentiments, how a society perceives goals. For example, if we talk about the goals of a society or goals of a social system particularly, every individual who is committed to that social system is pursuing a goal which will be at the interest of the entire system. So each and every member who are interconnected with each other in the social system network, they will be contributing towards the pursuing of that goal, however what different efforts they carry out. For example, power also rests, because social social system also looks at power hierarchies. And for example, if you look into power differentials, there are different hierarchical gradations in the society. But yes, though, in spite of hierarchies, all these hierarchical relations are interdependent upon each other. So there is no system of not adhering to power relations. For example, I'll give a simple example here. In a joint family system, where the role of karta was institutionalized by the family norms, like earlier, now the joint family has though slightly started disintegrating, and the role of karta is also becoming less. Yeah, but still, in certain villages and certain parts of India, the role of karta becomes very prominent. He is at the supreme power of the household, and he maintains the entire system. That is how, you know, members contribute towards listening to the powers or listening to the viewpoints or orders given by the karta. So everything, be it a decision on a property, be it a decision in anything, has to go through the karta. So that is how power becomes very important. And then when we talk about sanction facility, whether it is socially sanctioned, as for example, when we talk about a system to operate, like a system in India, a social system in India, when we say that earlier in India, same gotra marriages, intercaste marriages were not promoted, but through Special Marriage Act 1954, it has been promoted,
yeah.
And people have the state has in fact looked at these exploitative practices,
yeah.
Or looked at these discriminatory practices in a different way. Similarly, the Dowry Prohibition,
yeah,
Act, the Child Marriage Restraint,
yeah.
Act. All these acts have been very pro-women and gender-friendly acts, where girl children or women,
yeah.
were exploited long time in the past. They have actually uplifted the status of women,
yeah.
and through a social sanction mechanism.
Yeah.
Like a remarriage as well.
Yes,
earlier,
widow remarriages,
yeah.
widow remarriages.
So as the society progresses, we have rules, regulations.
That are evolving as well along with the society.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And that is how a system operates. I mean, as I was telling in the
yeah.
beginning also, they are the operational guidelines which decide the functioning of a system. So when we see society evolving,
yeah.
the operational guidelines also change as per the demands of the society.
Society.
That is how it is happening.
Yeah.
I mean, in when we maintain the system and maintain relations within the system.
So Mr. Sukant, would you like to sum up the discussion that we've had so far?
Yeah. So, dear learner, today we discussed about what is social structure, what is social system, and how we can maintain a social good, so better social structures. So, we've discussed about in society we have number of systems, like we have political system, we have economic system, we have legal system, and everyone plays its own role to make a better social structure. So I can tell you, learner, that you behave what is expected by the society, so that we can have a proper social system, and even you will benefit a lot from prevailing rules and regulations in our society.
So learners, today we discussed about social system and social structure and realized it's vast and in which everybody works towards the same goal. If you have any query, you can definitely contact us. Our address is... You can listen to our audio programs on the website of NIOS or our web radio, Mukt Vidyavani. I would like to thank Dr. Elina Samantre and Mr. Sukant Mahapatra for joining us today at the studio of NIOS. We wish you all the best, and we will be back very soon with different topics and different subjects.
प्रकाशित करने राहों को आलोकित करने हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े